Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends. In this video, we are going to solve a problem based on the types of errors like the limiting error. So here we are going to solve a problem where we have to calculate the limiting error in the measurement. So let us take our problem. So our problem is, we are given a 4-dial decade box. 4 dials are present in that. We are having decade A, decade B, decade C and decade D. So this dial box, it can measure the resistances in the range of 1000. So decade A, it is denoting the 10 into 1000 ohm resistance, and the error in that is plus minus 0.1%. Then decade B is measuring the 10 into 100 ohm resistance, and the error is plus minus 0.1%. Decade C, it is measuring the 10 into 10 ohm resistance, plus minus 0.5% is the error. Decade D is measuring 10 into 1 ohm resistance, and plus minus 1% is the error. Now this 4-dial decade box, it is set at 4639 ohms of reading. Now we have to find out the percentage limiting error and the range of the resistance values. The error in each reading is given to us, and we have to find out the total error, total limiting error we have to find out. Also, we have to find that what will be the range of the resistance value. So let us try to solve this problem. Now we are given in the question that the decade means this dial box, it is set at the resistance value of 4639. Means the dial box is reading the value 4639. Now this dial box, it is having 4 decades, decade A, B, C and D. So if we split this value, it can be split in the form 4000 plus 600 plus 30 plus 9. So that will be equal to 4639. Now if we see in the question, we are given that the decade A, it is reading the 1000 value, decade B is reading the 100 value, decade C is reading the 10 units value, and decade D is reading the 1 value. So this is 1000, 100, tens and units. So if we say this is our thousands, so it will be measured by the decade A. 600 is indicated by the decade B, 30 is indicated by decade C, and 9 is indicated by decade D. So error in each decade is given to us. In A, we are having the error plus minus 0.1%. In B, we are having plus minus 0.1%. C, we are having plus minus 0.5%. And in D, we are having plus minus 1%. So in each reading, we can find out the errors. Okay. When we are measuring at 4000, the reading will be 4000 into 0.1 upon 100, because it is in percentage, and here we will have plus minus sign. So we will get the error as plus minus 4 ohms. Because when we remove this, we will get 10. So we are getting the answer as plus minus 4 ohm. Now for decade B, the reading is 600, error is plus minus 0.1%, again plus minus 600 into 0.1%. So when we remove this, we will get, so our reading is plus minus 0.6 ohm. Okay. Due to this decade C, reading is 30, so 30 into 0.5 upon 100. When we remove this, we will get 10. This will be 2. So we will get 0.15 plus minus 0.15 ohm. Okay. Then we are having decade D. So decade D is reading 9. 9 into 1 upon 100. Okay. So it will be 0.09 ohms. Plus minus. So due to each decade, we have find out that what will be the error in the resistance value. Decade A is giving us the error at this reading as 4 ohms. Decade B is giving 0.6 ohm. Decade C is giving 0.15. Decade D is giving 0.09 ohm. So if we found out the total error will be the sum of all these. Okay. So plus minus 4 plus 0.6 plus 0.15 plus 0.09. So we will get it as plus minus 4.84 ohms. So this is the total error which has occurred at this reading 4639. Now in the question we are asked that we have to find out the percentage limiting error. So first we will find out the limiting error and then we will find out the percentage limiting error. So error we have calculated, the limiting error will be 0.05. So we are finding here the relative limiting error, which is the represented by epsilon r er, and it is the ratio of the error divided by the value, the true value of the resistance. So error is 4.84, that is the total error, and reading of the resistance is 4639. So when we divide this, we will get the relative limiting error as plus minus 0.00104. Okay, when we divide these two numbers, we will get 0.00104. Now we have to find out the percentage limiting error. So for percentage limiting error, we are going to multiply it with 100. So plus minus 0.00104 into 100. When we remove this decimal sign, we will get 00 will be here. So we will have 0.104% plus minus. So this is the percentage limiting error. Now we have to find out the range of the resistance value. So for this we are given that the value of the resistance is 4639 and the total error occurring is plus minus 4.84. Okay, so if we approximate this 4.84, we can write it as 4639 plus minus 5 ohms. Okay, so the range of resistance values will be either 4639 plus 5 or 4639 minus 5. So when we are adding 5, we will get 4, 6, 4, 4, and when we are subtracting, we will get 4, 6, 3, 4. Okay, so the range of values for the resistance can be from 4, 6, 3, 4 to 4, 6, 4, 4. Okay, so any in this range, the resistance can have value like from 4, 6, 3, 9 plus minus 5 ohms. We can write it as the range of the values for the resistance. So in this video, we solved the problem in which we have to find out the percentage limiting error and the range of the resistance value. We are given a 4-dial decade box and all the decade values are given, and in each decade, the percentage error is given to us. So at that reading 4639, we have calculated that what will be the error due at this reading 4639, and then we calculated the total error. With the help of that, we calculated the percentage limiting error and then the range of the resistance value. So I hope that this problem is clear to you. Thank you.